Hey friends, welcome back. In today's video, I want to talk about two apps that I use all the time on my iPad as an architect and illustrator, Procreate and Morpholio Trace. I got a lot of questions like, can Morpholio replace Procreate or do we really need both? We can clearly say they have a lot of similarities, but they also have some key differences that makes each one of them unique in their own way. So in this video, I will break down what each app truly excels at, how they compare, and how I personally use them in my own workflow. By the end, you'll have a much clearer idea of which one is right for you, or whether, like me, you might find that using both makes the most sense, each for a different purpose. So let's go! Before starting, I would like to thank the sponsor of this video, Skywork AI. Skywork is an AI-powered productivity and workspace platform designed to help people and teams create professional-grade work quickly. It combines deep research capabilities with specialized AI agents that automate tasks across multiple content formats. This is great if you are an architect or designer who wants to create presentations, documents, posters, and datasheets without jumping between different apps. Instead of a single general assistant, it uses multiple agents, each tailored for core tasks. You can create amazing slides from just a topic or transcript. It researches everything for you, finds the best images, and gives you a polished presentation ready to present. You can also create eye-catching posters, professional documents, whether it's a resume, a research report, or a client proposal, all with AI assistance. And then there are sheets for managing your budgets and timelines, plus deep research tools to pull data straight from the web. Skywork AI brings everything together in one place. You can go from idea to finished presentations in minutes. The interface is very simple and intuitive, anyone can do it. The templates are already tailored for your industries, so the results look polished and professional right out of the box. And of course, you can add, delete, or edit anything on it directly. I'm impressed by how Skywork's AI works. It really delivers. You can find it in the link in the description below. Try it and let me know what you think. All right, let's jump back into the video. So first, let's quickly define both apps in simple terms. Procreate is a digital drawing and painting app. It's made for illustrations, concept art, visual notes, sketching, and really any kind of illustration. I use Procreate when I want to do illustrations, diagrams, and storyboards. Sketch ideas freely to explore and brainstorm without worrying about the scale. Create visuals for presentations, YouTube or social media, or take notes during meetings or while learning. I really like the fact there is a huge library of brushes for sketching, painting, and texturing, and you can also create your own. And I believe this is where Procreate really shines for illustrators. Your drawings can have a lot of personality because the brushes feel so different from each other. Procreate also gives you a ton of flexibility to experiment with your layers. I basically use Procreate like Photoshop most of the time, and I find it very similar to Photoshop because you have a lot of options that lets you play with the colors, with the layer settings and the mask, the blending modes and opacity changes, for example. Now, from an architect or designer's point of view, the big limitation is that Procreate doesn't have a native scale system. It's not meant to be a precision drafting tool. You can still work around it by importing a scaled reference or by using grid, for example, but it's always a bit manual. So for anything that needs to be precisely to scale, Procreate is not ideal. Morpholio Trace is made specifically for architects and designers. It's built around drawing over plans, images, or PDFs working to scale and doing fast architectural iterations. I use it when I want to sketch directly over plans, sections, elevations, or site photos, work to a specific scale and keep proportions accurate, do quick iterations on layouts and concepts, or add annotations and hatches to drawings. I really like the fact that we can set a scale, and once this is done, everything, your lines, dimensions, and measurements follows that scale. For plans, sections, and elevations, this is a game changer. You're not just sketching kind of right, it's actually very proportional. Also, we have the stencils, a big library of furniture, people, trees, cars, and architectural symbols. You can just drop them into your drawing to add context and scale really fast without redrawing everything from scratch. And also you can quickly hatch areas, add fills, textures, and even calculate areas. And I find this very helpful. The limitations compared to Procreate is the brush variety and the overall art side. The brushes are more basic, which is enough for architectural sketching, but not ideal if you want some textured illustrations. So for quick, precise architectural thinking, Morpholio is great. For rich illustration work, not that much. Now let's put them side by side and see how they compare in a few key areas. Procreate is made for art and illustration. Morpholio Trace is more for design sketching. About the scale and precision, Morpholio wins here. It has a real scale, measurements, and tools that understand architectural drawings. Procreate is more freeform. You can fake scale, but it's not built-in. If you care about texture, paint early effects, inking styles, and overall visual richness, Procreate wins. Morpholio is more minimal here, clean, sketchy, and efficient. Procreate's layer system is more advanced, closer to Photoshop. It's better for complex illustration, composition, and post-processing. Morpholio's trace layer system is simpler but more tailored to stacking design iterations. And for the use cases, for conceptual architectural sketches to scale, Morpholio is great. But for final illustrations, diagrams, presentation images, Procreate is better. For annotations, PDFs, and plan on site, Morpholio is great. And for storyboarding, thumbnails, and visual note-taking, Procreate is better. About the pricing, Procreate has a one-time payment of around $13, and Morpholio, the app itself, can be downloaded for free, but some features will be locked, and to unlock them, you'll have to buy a pro membership, and I think this costs around $20 a year. So which one should you get? If you're mainly an illustrator, concept artist, or you want to create beautiful visuals and storytelling images, start with Procreate. You'll get way more out of the brush engine, layers, and drawing tools. If you are mainly an architect, interior designer, or urban designer, and you want to sketch over plans, work to scale, and iterate on layouts, Morpholio Trace will feel much more like home. If you are like me, somewhere in between, honestly, the best combo is both. I use Morpholio to think in plan and section, to sketch to scale. Then I use Procreate to create visuals, diagrams, and illustrations based on those ideas. And one last thing I want to mention is how nicely these two can also work together. You can start a sketch or plan in Morpholio at scale, export it as an image or PDF, import it into Procreate to do color, texture, people, vegetation, and final touches. So it doesn't have to be Procreate or Morpholio. It can also be Procreate and Morpholio as a really strong team. Alright, so these are my thoughts and my way of using Procreate and Morpholio Trace together. This is based on my own workflow as an architect and illustrator. It doesn't mean this is the only way to use them. I would actually love to know your way. Do you use one of them, both of them, or maybe something completely different? Just let me know. And that's it for this video. If you still have some time, you can check this other video here where I show you how I use these apps in my workflow. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!